How to turn a YouTube video into a podcast. Oh, this is one of the key tenets around here. This is one of the big things that we like to do to help maximize what you're actually producing. So there are a few things that you need to set up ahead of time before you can do that, and then we'll actually go into what you need to do to make that happen right after this. Now, by the end of this video, we're going to tell you how to exactly to turn your YouTube video into a podcast, effectively doubling your efforts off the exact same recording. So I'm glad you asked. Here we go. I'm Nic Natarella with AdWise Creative, and one of the big things that we do around here is try to make the most out of what we've done. Instead of having to reinvent the wheel or do things two, three, four times again and again and again, what can we do once and then multiply and leverage what we've done? Well, taking your YouTube video and turning it into a podcast is one of the key things that you can do to maximize your efforts and maximize your exposure with the exact same thing. Now, there's two ways to do this. There's the YouTube way and there's the podcast way. So first, let's look at the YouTube way. When you go to YouTube, you know, YouTube is broken up into segments. You've got your long form content, and the long form content is even broken up into playlists. Sometimes a video is part of a playlist, sometimes it's not. So if it's not, it's going to be on the front page. If it is part of a playlist, it could be on the front page and in the playlist. And then there's also a tab for shorts. Shorts is becoming all the rage now, but there's also podcasts. And YouTube wants a piece of that podcast pie desperately because it has become so popular ever since COVID. Now, a lot of people started a podcast during COVID and then they quit once they ended up going back to work. But there are a lot of folks who decided to stick around with it and some other folks who are now starting to come back around to it to produce their own podcast. And YouTube wants a piece of that podcasting pie because what do you do with podcasts? You put more ads on them. So that's what YouTube wants to do. So to turn your YouTube channel into a podcast is very simple. You can do it one of two ways. You can go to playlists and start a brand new playlist. And when it asks you for the title, it will also ask you, is this a podcast? You click yes. Give it the title, hit save, and you are up and running. You've got your podcast playlist ready to go. And the next time you upload something, you choose that as the playlist, and there it is under the podcast heading. The other way to do it is kind of like just what I said. On your first upload, it'll ask you, is this part of a playlist? Then you say yes, then you say it's a podcast, and you give it the new title, and you hit yes, and then when you hit upload, it'll go to that brand new playlist, which is now your podcast. Not exactly sure what YouTube is going to be doing with these podcast playlists, but they want to start segmenting them now. That way, when they do have it ready to go and ready to roll out, well, I'm sure they've got an idea of what they want to do with it. They just haven't told us yet. Once they know exactly what they're going to do and how they're going to do it, they've already got it segmented out and they'll be able to roll out whatever it is they want to do immediately. Like I said, this is one of the big things we like to do around here is maximize our efforts. We don't like doing things two, three, four times. We like doing it once. So if you want to get your YouTube channel or your podcast up and running, click like, click subscribe if you want to keep getting these tips and techniques and stuff that you need to know on how to do this for your business podcast or YouTube channel. And we'll get you up and running quickly. Those are all the video exports. Now, some of them will have, most of them will have, an audio export version. And let me give you a quick overview of what that's going to look like. This isn't going to be all for all software. In fact, like I've said before, I use DaVinci Resolve. This is how you export audio only out of DaVinci Resolve. Let's take a look. So now that you've finished the entire podcast, in fact, this is a podcast that I work on a weekly basis. Here's everything that's done. This is the subtitles and the lower thirds and some graphics and things like that. Here's the video and the audio, the intro and the outro. So here's the entire podcast. It's running about 30 minutes or so. Now, how do we output or render just the audio? Well, there are a couple different things when it comes to DaVinci Resolve. First of all, if you remember, there are two kinds of DaVinci Resolve. You can get the free version. That comes with a, you in the options, you can mix down a wave version, and a wave version only, I shouldn't say only, but many places are expecting an MP3. The MP3 codec is in the studio version. Now, it's not a bad thing to have to go to, say, another online service to maybe convert it from WAV to MP3. That's fine. It's just an extra step. Studio versus the free version of DaVinci Resolve, the MP3 is already built into the studio version, and you can mix it directly into that. So let's get over to, this is the deliver page. Right now we're in the audio, edit page. We're going to skip over to the deliver page. And this is where you do all your mixing down, whether it be for video, YouTube, Vimeo, Twitter, TikTok, any kind of presentation, blah, 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 blah. You can even export it into Final Cut Pro or Premiere, or that's the one we're looking for right there, audio only. So you click on your audio only. Now, one of the biggest things you have to watch out for, and I try to do this at the very, very beginning. What are you going to mix down? Just a section of it? Or do you need the entire timeline? Well, chances are you're going to want the entire timeline. But every once in a while, this little booger will be changed to the in-out range. And chances are it'll be to some small 1, 2, 5, 7 minute segment. So always make sure that the entire timeline is selected here, because that's what we want to render. I'm telling you, it will turn around and bite you. Trust me, it's happened, and you'll probably learn it from experience too. But that's the biggest tip I can give you right here, is make sure it's set to entire timeline and not the in-out range, because chances are your in-out range is going to be set really short. So let's give it a title. Let's call this Your Podcast Render. And, of course, you can call it episode whatever and who the guest is and all that kind of stuff. And then where do you want to save it to? You pick the folder, do the browse method, and you can pick the folder where you want it saved. Now we're going to come down to this line, and we want to make sure to choose audio. We're going to be exporting our audio. And this is where you make your change. This is where you make your choice. And, again, in the studio version, the paid version, MP3 is here. Another version is WAV. That's the default, and it's also the default in the free version, and then you'll have to go someplace else to mix it down to convert it to MP3. But here, skip a step, you can go straight to MP3. Now, what kind of parameters do you need for this? Chances are most podcast hosting services, they want to see 192 kbps or better. 320, that's a bit overkill. So I always bring mine down to 192. And then whether it's 48K or whether the sample rate is 44.1 or 48, take your pick. Either one of those are fine. Again, for the spoken word and for most audio resources, 48 is probably more than what you need. But for me, I just leave it there. And the bit depth, I leave it at 32. You can probably do 32 or 24. Since it's the only one here, I'm just going to go with that. Now, what is going to be our output track? What is DaVinci Resolve going to be listening to create your audio file? In this case, we want the bus one, the stereo mixdown. So that way, the intro and outros and all their sound effects and music, that will be in stereo, and then your voiceover will be in mono, but it'll be both mono in the left and right channel together, so you'll have a full audio mix down. So make sure this is set to bus one. You don't want to accidentally leave something out, so make sure you're on the stereo output. Now, if you want to, if this might be a shortcut for you. Me personally, I like to play in the audio tab. I'll be over here in the Fairlight tab, and I'll mess with a bunch of stuff to make sure my levels are all normal and everything. But if you need to normalize your audio and you want to bring it to a specific target level based off the output track, this is where you would do it here. So that may even save you a step than having to mess with all of this in the Fairlight tab. So experiment, and again, you can probably do that with your in-out tabs and just do a little tiny section. This could take a little while, but with everything set, you've got your entire timeline, you've picked whether you want MP3 or WAV, you've got everything set, gave it a label, sent it to its destination.
we're going to make this our render. And this is going to add to these, we want these settings added to the render queue. This is the render queue up here. So watch, when I click this, it should pop up here. There we go. This one is now ready to go, and we are about to render it down to the brand new episode. And all you do, now I've done the video, I've done the audio, so I've already got the YouTube and the podcast episodes, but this one, and I can show it to you real quick, this is not going to take long at all. We're going to hit render, and it should take about, the time's getting shorter and shorter and shorter and shorter, but that's all it does. Notice down here, it's going through your podcast, and that's what it's rendering. And when it's all said and done, you should have a brand new audio file ready to go wherever you have chosen to save it. And that's the very simple way to render just the audio, i.e. your podcast episode, in DaVinci Resolve.
See, it's very simple. A few adjustments to how you want to have this to export, or like they say in video, render, the way you render it, and then you are done. Send it off to your podcast hosting service, and they will distribute it from there. You've got your podcast and your video all done from the exact same edit. That's called working smarter, not harder. That's called making the most out of what you've already done and replicating it and leveraging it to go even further. Now, to help you in this endeavor, to be able to switch from video to audio and back and forth, there's a bunch of free audio editing software out there, and I have a free guide for you to take you through those various audio programs. There is a link in the description. Click on it right now and you get that free download. It's free audio editing software to help you make all this kind of stuff. It's got software that'll work on Mac, that'll work on PC, even Linux, different audio softwares. And the cool thing is they're all free. You can try them all out for as long as you want, kick the tires, okay? And then a few of them, you can even upgrade to a paid version. Some of the paid versions are a one-time pay, and then some of the paid versions are also a subscription. So just be aware of that when you upgrade. But to start with, the stuff that is on this free guide is free to start with. So get your copy right now by clicking the link in the description. I'm Nic Natarella from AdWise Creative. Thank you for watching.